Hello students, today we are going to study chapter 2, our sense organs of class 4 EVS. So have you ever heard about sense organs? Do you know which all are sense organs, children? So I would like to tell you the name of our sense organs. They are eyes, nose, tongue, ears and our skin. So let's start the chapter. Our body is like a huge machine that works with help of different organs. We have got many organs in our body. They are both internal and external. External organs are the organs that we can see with our eyes, and the internal organs we cannot see them. Our sense organs help us to experience the world around us. Our eyes tell us that a rose is red. Our nose tells us that it is sweet smelling. Our skin tells us to handle it carefully because it has prickly thorns, and our ears tell us that the bees are buzzing for the rose nectar. So we better stay away. Now, first sense we are going to discuss is sense of smell. Our sense of smell tells us many things. We can smell a dead rat before we actually see it, and we can tell if a food item has become stale merely by sniffing at it. Similarly, the smell of our favorite food being cooked makes us hungry. Actually, what we smell are tiny things called odor or smell particles. Millions of these odor particles mix with the air around us. As we breathe in, the odor particles enter through our nostrils. They travel up the nose, where some special smell detecting cells are located. The particles stick to the tiny cells and send signals to the brain that tells us whether the smell is good or bad. You must have felt these smells at your home as well. As you, for example, you can tell your father that your deodorant is smelling very nice, and you can ask your mother that why drainage is smelling so badly. Okay, so these are the examples of sense of smell that we can feel using our nose. Now, our sense of smell is also a matter of personal choice. Some of us like the smell of garlic, fish and mustard oil, but some of us may find these very strong and unpleasant. It really depends on our choice also. Okay, some of us are allergic to certain smells. Pleasant smells make us happy, while unpleasant smells can cause uneasiness. Most of us find the smell of perfumes, flowers and scented cleaners very pleasant, but some of us do not like them at all. The smells which are very powerful are not liked by everyone because it may cause headache also. Now, moving to the next part, it is sense of touch. It is felt by our skin. Our skin helps us to feel that we touch. While the other four sense organs are located in specific parts of our body, but the skin is all over our body. The sense of touch is all over our body. The skin covers our whole body in multiple layers. The sense of touch starts at the bottom layer of the skin, where there are nerve endings, as you see, you can see in this picture. These nerve delivers the information to the brain about the things with which our body comes in contact. So if we touch something prickly, that is very sharp, our brain tells us our hands to move away from the danger. The message travels along the nerves. Some parts of the body like hands, lips, face, neck, tongue, fingertips and feet are more sensitive than other because they have more nerve endings. So people who are blind can use their fingertips to read Braille. You have studied about Braille in your last class. It is a script that is used by visually impaired people to read to understand. Okay, now through this match the column, you can understand various fields. You will try it by your own. Okay, so In the next video, we are going to discuss some more things about our sense organs. That's all for today's part. Thank you.